same number of blocks across that you do here on your paper, and your photo should match. Okay? And then you should still, and you should have the same number of squares going down to match what you have here on your photo. So this is this. Okay? So what we're going to do, I'm going to kind of zoom in on this so you guys can see this better. Now for me, and I don't know what everybody's is a little bit different. For me, I don't have that much to draw in this very first box. So this first box isn't going to take me long at all, okay? Now when I get into stuff like that's over here, that's going to be a little bit more difficult, okay? It's going to take me a little bit longer. But some of this stuff up here is going to be a little bit easier. So when you guys look at this, okay, I have part of my construction paper that kind of goes here, and I see a little bit of another piece of construction paper. You can see these marks that we made around the outside edge of this blocker, I'm going to use to kind of help me graph, essentially, where this drawing needs to be. So when I look at where that edge is right here, it's between this middle mark and this mark right here. Now, if I want to, I can take this blocker and I can move it this way so I can see it just the way it is there. And I can see that this is going to hit. So it hits here between these two marks, and I'm going to put this. I'm going to put a mark right here where it hits there. So again, these are the same. Okay. And then I can see over here where the edge touches, and it touches and matches up right here at this mark. And that's the same as this mark right here. When you do that, okay, now I can connect, and for these lines are kind of angular, so I'm going to kind of match that, and then with that, and I actually have another line right here, too, and that connects really hard for you guys to see. So that's all that I'm going to draw for that block. Once I get that one done, then I can move on to the next one. Now I can move, this was sort of, this blocker was designed by another student that I had years ago. They really liked it. It's actually worked out really well. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move to the next one next to it to the right. Now if I wanted to, I could go down. But when you do this, what's important is that you move to the block next to you. You don't move over here to a block on the other side, okay, or in another area, you just move to the block next to it. And the reason why that's important is because this is going to help ensure that all the connections happen where they need to be. I'm going to turn this around again. I'm going to turn this around. Maybe this another way. That's what's nice about having this L-shaped block. Move it anywhere you want. So I'm going to block that one off. Same thing. So now I have a leaf here. So I can see on here that I have part of that leaf that hits this mark right here. Now, even though I don't have my blocker down here on the bottom, I can use this as my indicator. So I'm just going to make a mark there. I can see that part of the leaf hits that mark. I can see the edge of this leaf is right up above this mark, so I'm going to make a mark. So I'm just kind of making all these marks, and I'm going to essentially connect the dots. But this part that kind of touches in between these two marks, so I'm going to make a mark there. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to start drawing. Now, the edge of this leaf is kind of wavy. Let's zoom in a little bit. Kind of wavy. So first I'm just going to kind of very lightly kind of draw that in. It needs to, this scoop needs to go past this line. So And I've got like one, two, three bumps I have to do that. It's a little straight here. Got one bump, two bumps, three, four. Draw those bumps in. I'm going to draw this edge right here. And then on this particular leaf, I see sort of a really light section and a dark section. I want to take this edge so I can see where that is. Then I got the bumps. And then it's really skinny down here. So that's what that piece is going to look like. It doesn't look like much. It doesn't look like a leaf. But this is just a contour drawing. I'm going to be adding color and value to this to make it look like a leaf later. So once I'm done with that second block, now I'm just going to move over and do the third block. And this third block, again, I don't have too much going on. So this is going to go probably a bit quicker than the second one. You'll find that each one takes a different amount of time to do. For this one, I just have a little part of the leaf peeking through. And again, I need to make sure that it connects to this one the right way. And what's nice about having this L shape is that I can leave this open and I can make sure that that connection is happening the way it needs to do. And out. So this goes not quite out to this part, so I want to keep this kind of on the in the inside of this. And then I have this change happening. There's a corner and then it juts in. It needs to happen about right here. And then I have, on this particular part, I see a dark shadow on the bottom part and it's lighter here on the top. So I am going to draw where I see that edge happening. Which then in turn connects into this other box. I'm going to add just more details into this. So this drawing is not going to look like a, you know, it's going to look more like a topographical map than it will like a finished drawing. It's when we add our color, our values, highlights, things like that, that it's going to look great. Now I do have a little part of a radish peeking through here, so I'm going to go ahead and add that. I can see that the edge of the radish hits about this mark down here. Since my blocker's not right here, I can use the marks right up above there. Please take note of how I did add additional marks to my blocker. Add in that edge of the radish. Again, once I'm done, I'm going to just keep moving on, okay? One at a time. And see, what's nice is that once you get several of these done, you know, you have your blocker now that spans now that I'm on the fourth one, it can span all of these. I am going to go ahead and just divide each one of these spaces in half again. I'm just using my eyes rather than a ruler. If you're not very good at using your eyes to divide things in half, you may want to grab a ruler. I'm going to go ahead and do that on all of those, just so I can see. So now I can just go back and I can recheck what I did just to make sure that everything is matching up. But essentially what I have at this point, I'll kind of show you, I have my first three blocks done. I'll block that off. So I have this, what I have finished right now. I'm working on the fourth. All right, I'm just going to keep going. Now after I'm done with the top row, I can go back down and I can start working on the second row. And that's how we're going to do that. All right, you want to make sure you get, you know, as much detailed information as possible with this, because this is what's telling you where everything needs to go. And again, if your grid is not measured out correctly, if your blockers are not measured out correctly on both the paper and the photograph, you are going to get a wacky drawing, okay? So, and definitely make sure, one of the things that I have found that sometimes gets kids in trouble is that they are working on the wrong block in the wrong place. So always make sure that you're in the right place. I always double check before I start. So I've got it now blocked off and ready for the next one. Okay? So that's what we're going to do today. You should get a lot of this done today. Some of you might even get yours finished. But if you're interested in the schedule for this week, it is up on the board and it's on campus. There you go.